Hey, dear viewers, it's the star, Zion Holistic, the IT guy. Today, I'll be answering the Southwest Regional Mock Examination 20K20 Ordinary Level Computer Science Paper 2. Question 7, which is the last question on the paper. If you don't have this paper, make sure you click on the link below to download this question paper and follow along with me. Okay, let's dive directly into the question and answer them. Let's answer this question. So let's start with 7A. 7A reads, you have been asked to buy system units and monitors for your school computer laboratory. Give 3 core characteristics each that will guide your choice of monitor and a system unit. Okay, when you are going to buy a monitor, 3 things you need to put in mind is there. First is the type. The type which deals with the display technology. Second, the size, which deals with the inches. Thirdly, resolution, which deals with the pixel. Then for the monitor, the 3 things you need to know are the processor speed, the RAM capacity, and the hard disk drive capacity. These are the 3 things you need to know for each of the following monitor and the system unit. They'll be explained further below. Question 2. For each of the devices, say why the mentioned characteristics are important. Okay, the mentioned characteristics are important. Let's start with the monitor. For the monitor, we're going to talk about the display technology was the first point of there. For display technology, let's note that we have 3 types of monitors. We have the cathode ray tube, we have the liquid crystal display, and we have the light emitting diode. This will help us to know to select based on the light intensity, the color quality, and the contrast. For example, the cathode ray tube emits light through cathode ray incident on fluorescent material. For the liquid crystal display, it uses the cold cathode fluorescent lamp. For the light emitting diode, it uses the light emitting diode. So these various ways of light emission will have an impact on our eyes, and we need to choose, because from there we're going to have different light intensity, the color quality, and the contrast. And I would like you to note that this one was the first. From this, the liquid crystal replaced the light, the cathode ray tube, and the light emission diode is now replacing the liquid crystal display. And whenever we have a change of technology, it comes with more better characteristics than the previous one. So the best here, I think, is the light emitting diode. That is the best. But it depends on your financial situation too, because this one is also very cheap compared to the others. So if your school is a poor school, you need to just go and buy this type and put in your laboratory. Let's talk about the inches, that is the size. We have the 4.3, the 16.9, and the 21.9 inches. So this is the smallest in terms of size, and this is the biggest in terms of size. And the bigger the size, we have more work surface, which will lead to more side-by-side tasks, that is multitasking on the same desktop. Whereas when it is small, you face difficulties to accomplish these 2 points here, that is the work surface and the side-by-side task. With the resolution, which deals with a pixel, more pixel means images will be sharper and you'll be able to see whatever you are working on more clearly. If you look at these pixels here, the various displays of the resolution, it starts here with 480, very faint. It becomes clearer a bit with 720 pixel, Yeah, we continue with 1080 pixel and we go to 4K, which is 2160 pixel. This one here has a sharper and brighter image. That is dealing with the resolution. You have to know these things before you buy. So when you have a very big screen, large size of monitor, it can go up to 2160p. But with the other small sizes in terms of inches, in terms of inches like a 4.3 and a 16.9, you cannot go up to that 4K in terms of resolution. Let's now talk about the system unit. For the system unit, talking about the processor speed, let's explain why the processor speed is very important for us to know when buying our computer system. Processor speed is the number of cycles per second at which the central processing unit of a computer processes data. Very important. Processor speed is measured in gigahertz and is essential to the ability to run applications. For example, a CPU with a clock rate of 1.8 gigahertz can perform 1800 million clock cycles per second. Very important. So the clock speed shows the number of cycles per second. When talking about this, you have to have the notion of what we call the machine cycle of a computer. The machine cycle. So from there, you can know how many machine cycles can occur in a second. If you have a computer of 1.8, it can take 1800 million cycles per second. There's a way of verifying this. If I show you my characteristics, I have a 2.6 gigahertz times 2. I have 2.6 gigahertz times 2, which makes it extremely fast at this level for this computer, but compared to other computers, there are other very powerful computers. The RAM capacity. Why should we talk about RAM capacity? Is very important because that is where nearly everything that needs to go to the CPU must pass through. So the RAM holds all the instruction and data that the processor needs to use when running a program. So suppose you want to run several programs that is multitasking on your computer, for example, a text editor, a browser with three open tabs, and a business program, a good capacity RAM will be needed, or else your PC will be very slow and maybe freezing frequently. So when you see those computers are always freezing when so many applications are being run on them, it's because of the RAM. They have a very low RAM. They need to upgrade the RAM and install RAMs with higher capacity. For the hard disk capacity, greater capacity for the hard disk equals to greater storage space. That's all for that. So the greater the capacity, you can store more information in your hard disk drive. So these things are supposed to be put into consideration when you are going to buy a computer for your laboratory. Okay. Define the terms network topology. Let's define the term network topology. Network topology is just like the visual representation of the computer network. What you can see, the visual representation of the computer network, or you can still define it as a physical and logical arrangement of computers in a network. Yeah. Number two, sketch the diagram of a mesh topology with five computers. Let's sketch this diagram. Mesh topology with five computers. Do I even have a diagram of a computer here? Let me see. Let me sketch this diagram using a text box. I will draw a text box here. I will import, insert, computer, this one here, good, five of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for the mesh topology. From the one to the curiosity. For the next topology, all the computers must be connected to each other. They must be connected, just like you say in French, the rasta. So the rastas need to pass everywhere. Let's look at our connector. Yes, let me take this one. I connect it like this. I try to increase the width. Yes, I think that is good. Let me also connect it here. I think that is good for the mesh topology. I think all the computers are connected to each other. Each other, one, two, no. One last one. This and this. Each computer should have four, one, two, three, four for this. 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 One. Yes, so this is what we call the mesh topology with five computers. The rasters are connecting each of the computers. See, prolonged use of the computer can lead to certain health hazards. One, name three of such health hazards. We have musculoskeletal problems, vision problems, and repetitive stress injury. So we further explain below. Select any of the health hazards above and suggest two ways to prevent it. Let's start with the musculoskeletal problem. To prevent the musculoskeletal problem, you have to find a correct height for both your desk and chair so that your computer screen is at eye level or slightly lower. Are you seeing this, our lady here? A very serious woman. She's just respecting, she will just respect all these conditions here. I have seen her eyes fixed to the screen, straight. Sit with your back straight. Yes, it's very straight. The back is very straight. Leg at 90 degrees. Yeah, 90 degrees angle to the floor. Very serious. And feet resting flat on the floor. Yeah, keep respect. Always take small breaks from your computer work to stretch your muscles, keep your blood flowing, and to rest your eyes. Yeah, I know she will do that after. Right now, she's very fixed. Obeying the conditions. Let me just show you another image for this, another sphere. Okay, here's the right one and here is the wrong one. This one does not respect the conditions listed below. For the vision problem, maintain a proper vision distance from the screen and do not forget to blink. You have to blink. Look at this other madam here. She's so close to the screen. Meanwhile, this is the appropriate distance from your eyes to the screen for you not to have this vision problem. Make sure to adjust the brightness of your computer screen so that your eyes are not as strained. Yeah, the adjustment is done at the level of the monitor. You can do all those adjustments, the contrast, brightness, luminosity, and color. Repetitive stress injury. For this one, it means that to prevent it, you have to type gently to decrease the stress put on each of your fingers. Relax your arms and try to get a few stretches in when you are not typing or using your mouse. Dear friends, we have come to the end of the Southwest Regional Mock Examination, Computer Science, Paper 2, Ordinary Level. I thank you all for watching, and don't forget to click on like and to subscribe on the channel, because I will answer more questions and post in my YouTube channel. God bless you guys, and have a nice time. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen.